Hey, my name is Derek.
And I'm Shanae.
And we are your Game Masters. Hello, hello. Hey, you guys excited to have an awesome time at VBS?
I don't know. Do they look excited to you?
If you are excited for VBS, give me a yeah.
Yeah.
Hey.
I don't know.
They sound excited, but
good.
I think they could be more excited.
I think they could go a little more than
let's
that.
Let's give them one more chance.
All right.
Right? Are you excited for VBS?
Whoa!
Whoa! All right.
Wow, they are you guys ready to have
a lot of fun playing games with us? Yeah? Okay, we're gonna start off with a game called Table Game. Right? We have a game called Table, and this is how it goes. Whoop! Ooh! Okay. All right. So we have two people out there. They're already out there. Okay. Okay, and then they're gonna come up, they're gonna run, and then they're gonna come up right here, and then they're gonna do 10 jumping jacks, like this. 10 jumping jacks. And then they're gonna come run over here, and then they're gonna run, open this box, throw this box down, and then they're gonna have to say what this is. I'm not saying it because I don't wanna give it away. And then they have to go like this. And then they're gonna open this up. And then the best. And then they have to run over here. And then they finish. Whoever finishes faster, they win. Are you guys excited? Yeah, but we have to make sure that when they do jumping jacks, they can't do it like this. They have to do it. All right? So if they cheat, if they go like this, then you have to go boo, you have to do it again, okay? They have to do full jumping jacks. Are you guys ready? All right,
wow.
Here we go. Who's the first contestant? Are you guys ready? First contestant, go!
Here we come.
Go! Here we go.
Woo!
Go, 10 jumping jacks. Hurry up, 10 jumping jacks. Go, no, you have to do the full.
No, I gotta go faster.
Go. All right, hurry up, all right. Yeah. Come on over here. All right, good. Give it up for him. All right, our next contestant. Ready, go! Go. Run, full jumping jacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. Go. Name it out loud. All right. Who do you think won? Was it him or him? Okay. Yell really loud if you think it's him. All right. I think he's the winner. All right, okay, give it up, okay, you can go down.
Wow.
All right.
Was that fun, guys?
Can we have the jungle music to stop? My voice is going out. Okay. All right, so that was just for fun, okay? That was just for fun, but all the games we're gonna play, we're gonna divide it into teams now. Okay, teams. It's gonna be Team Shanae and Team Derek.
Right? Now, Derek, how do you think we should split up these teams?
Well, I know. Since it's a safari,
yeah?
Right? Let's name our favorite safari animal.
Favorite animal?
Yeah. Huh. What is your favorite safari animal?
My favorite safari animal, gotta be a really good one. I think it is the snake.
Snake? I'm scared of snakes.
Scared? They're so cool.
Really?
Yeah. Do you know why?
Why?
Because they make noise like this.
Ooh, see, that's why. Ooh. Ooh. That's scary.
Yeah. What's your favorite animal, Derek?
My favorite animal is a seal. Yeah, I know. I know what you're thinking. Hmm. What would a seal be doing in a safari, right? But how cool would it be if you saw a seal in a safari? Right?
That is true.
I'm a seal. I'm a seal. Hey,
why do you like seals, Derek?
Because they're silly.
Yeah?
They're silly like this, right? They go like this. Like that. They're silly like that. And so I think we should divide everybody into team slithering snakes. Is that what you guys are?
That's right.
Oh, okay. Our team is going to be the silly seals, right? And this is how we're going to do it. Like that, okay? And so why don't we have you guys do the slithering snakes? All right, everyone on this side, are you ready? Get
up,
get up. All right,
guys. Come on, let's show the seals how the slithering snakes are, okay? When I say 1, 2, 3, I'm going to have everyone go like this. Ready? All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Oh. You guys are scary.
That was really good.
All right, but hey, you guys ready?
All right, let's.
Silly seals, you guys ready? All right, get up, get up, get up. All right, okay. What? Two claps on this side and two claps on this side. Oh, okay, I see some people. You don't. It's not this. It's this. Okay? This is something else. Okay? All right, ready? On the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Okay, there we go. All right, that's us.
Right? All right.
So it's the slithering snakes versus the silly seals. Yeah.
We'll have to see when we play this game.
All right. You guys ready to play our first official slithering snakes versus the silly seal game?
Yeah!
Right? All right. So before we play this game, we have a Bible point that we want to share with you. And all our games are geared towards sharing a Bible point. What is the Bible point for today?
Kids, you guys know what today's Bible point is? Well, I will tell you what today's Bible point is. It is, our guide is the one true God. Can you say that with me?
Our guide is the one true God.
Right? Yeah. It's about finding who the true God is. Well, today's game is about finding the one true egg. Okay? The one true egg. Can we get our eggs out here?
The lovely assistant.
All right, we got eggs right here. All right, can we have our contestants out? All right, we got team
can
silly
I have,
seals right here.
Snakes on this side.
All right, what's your name?
Teresa.
What are you? Are you a slithery snake or a silly seal?
Silly seal.
That's right. Okay.
Faith.
She has a lot of faith, right? Is that what you mean? Oh, your name is Faith? Okay, all right.
All right, let's get this side introduced. What is your name?
Sarah.
All right, Sarah. What team are you part of?
What was it called?
Uh-oh.
Slithering snake.
It's a tongue twister.
It's a little bit of a tongue twister, but she'll get it by the second day, right? And your name?
Grace.
All right.
Give it up for the people here.
Woo!
All right, so this game is basically this. We have 12 eggs. 12 eggs. They will all pick one egg, And six of them are hard-boiled. And six of them are not. Right? And so they're going to pick one egg, and on the count of three, they're going to smash it on their head. Right? Right? Ready? Okay. Right, right there. Okay? And if they pick, okay, if they pick a hard-boiled egg, they are done. But if they pick a raw egg, they have to pick another egg until they get the hard-boiled egg.
The one true egg.
The one true egg. Okay?
That's right.
You don't want a runny egg. Okay? All right. All right. Who do you think's gonna win? Team Slithering? All right. Silly Seals?
What side are you on?
All right, here we go. Here we go. All right, ready? Drum roll. Pick an egg. Okay, all right, all right. Ready? Lean over on the table. Lean over on the table. Ready? On the count of three. One, two, three. Oh, she got a hard-boiled egg. She got a hard-boiled egg. Okay, you're out. You're out. All right. Okay. Ready? On the count of three. One, two, three. Oh! You got a hard-boiled? You got a hard-boiled, hard-boiled. Okay, come on to the middle. Come on to you guys can go. All right. Oh, okay, okay. Ready? On the count of... Wait, one, two, three. There's... Okay, ready? On the count of three. One, two, three. Oh! All right. Okay, all right. One more time, right? Okay, ready? One, two, three. One, two, three. Yeah! Thanks for being a good sport. All right. Put this back. Oi. All right. Did you guys have a lot of fun? Hey, we're gonna have a lot of fun, okay? So when you guys come in here, team...
Slithering Snake.
And team... Silly Seals. Right? Just get ready to have a lot of fun. A lot of, you know, and the rest of the day is filled with a lot of lessons, a lot of praising, and a lot of games. Have a lot of fun. Are you guys ready to praise?
All right, kids. Well...
Okay, so if you guys are ready to praise, why don't you guys stand up? Jiggle your bodies. Get ready for praise time. And here we go.
Here we go. See you tomorrow. See you later.
We worship our one true God.
Amen.
You guys, okay, check that. Your 2 feet are here. Are your 2 feet here? And
are
then your
here?
Two hands for your hands. And then we're going to do this all together. We're going to lift our hands up to our one true God.
Let's go.
Woo!
Y'all got to jump. Can you jump? Jump.
16 years ago, my mom and dad gave birth to me, and they named me Danielle. They were the best parents to grow up with. My mom taught me how to bake, and my dad taught me how to ride my bike. But when I turned 6, my mom became very ill, and we had to go to the hospital. That was the last time I saw my mother. She passed away later that night and went up to heaven to be with Jesus. Time went on, and my father and I had some ups and downs. It was difficult for him to go to work to pay the bills and raise me at the same time. But no matter what, we always kept our promise to take care of each other because that's what love looks like. But when I turned 12, my dad decided to do something that changed my life forever. My dad went on a mission trip to the Rocky Water Jungle to teach villagers about God.
We turn to the other breaking story tonight and take a look at the big screen right behind me here. That little circle right there, that is the eye of that monster storm. Cameras rolling, capturing the moment of impact. The trees ripped from the ground, down power lines, chaos at the airports. This evening, a new worry. Will all of this water now trigger landslides?
My dad, Michael, was still missing. People had been looking for them for months, but couldn't find any clues. One by one, each village in the Rocky Water Jungle started to lose faith in God. Since they did not have somebody to teach them more about God, people began to worship fake gods and statues. The entire jungle started to fall apart. Some villagers even began following and worshiping people. So it was my turn to find some answers about my dad's disappearance and teach the villagers about God. This is my story.
Oh, hi, I'm Danielle. My friends and I are going on a journey to the Rocky Water Jungle to search for my father, Michael. This is Shannon. This is Matthew.
Ah!
And this is my silly friend Afonso. And with God as our guide, we'll know his path and walk in it.
I think we're going the right way, guys. Wait, have we seen that rock before? I'm just looking at this map my dad left behind, but it doesn't make any sense. Wait, are we going north? No. Oh, we've been lost for like 5 hours. Man.
Ew. Why did I even follow her here? Like, there's so much mud in the jungle. She totally tricked me. She said that we're gonna go on vacation. This is not vacation. There's no signal here. What am I gonna do?
Danielle? Danielle?
Yes, Afonso?
Have you seen my chocolate bar?
No.
Oh, Shannon? Shannon?
What?
Have you seen my chocolate bar?
No.
Oh, I miss my chocolate bar. It was gonna be so yummy. It had chocolate in it, and I think it had marshmallows in it, and and mayonnaise. Oh, it's gonna be so yummy. Oh, I don't like this jungle. I'm so hungry.
Danielle? Danielle,
yes?
Where are you?
Matthew, we're over here.
Where? Can you just come get me? Shannon? Shannon, where are you?
Right here.
Where? Stuttberg. I think something's moving, Danielle! Wait, what is that? Ah!
They're just kids. Why are you so scared of them?
You guys, come on. I don't think we went this way before.
I'm pretty sure we did. Danielle, just face it. We're lost. And my beautiful luggage has mud all over it.
That's why I told you to pack light, Shannon.
Oh, I did pack light. Whatever, I'll just get a new one when I get home.
Man, where's my chocolate bar?
I don't want to like scare any of you guys, but I think I just saw a bear over there.
Matt, there are no bears in this jungle.
Yes, there are. Come on, I want to go home. We've been lost for hours.
Seriously, we have been lost for hours, and that map is not taking us. Wait, I forgot I had this. My GPS 3000.
Ooh, let me see that.
No, Matt, don't touch it. You're going to break it.
Oh, come on, Shannon, please. I promise not to.
Okay, fine, but be really careful, and you can't waste the battery.
System failed. Goodbye.
What? Matt!
What happened?
You broke it. That's what happened. And this is the only GPS mapping device I had.
Wait, GPS? I thought you said 3DS.
Are you serious? This is why I can't trust you with anything.
Whoa, Shannon. That's not fair. How can you blame Matthew for breaking the device? I mean, isn't it your fault for giving him the 3PS in the first place?
It's a GPS.
Whatever! GPS, 3PS, 3DS, it's all the same thing!
How is that the same thing at
it's
all?
It's the
what
same
thing! Is
thing.
Like, how
can first, you...
Like, I've never even heard of that before.
It's not the same thing.
Wait,
it's
just not
to break it. A GPS, a 3PS?
Guys!
What?
Can you please keep it down? I'm trying to read this map.
Yeah, guys,
she's okay, trying to read the map.
Guys! Come on, focus. Shannon, Afonso's right. You trusted Matthew with the GPS. You can't entirely blame him.
Never.
Matthew, you broke the GPS. You shouldn't try to touch anything else if you're going to break it.
Yeah, guys. Why can't you be like me? Just behave.
And Afonso, I saw you eat your chocolate bar 5 minutes ago. That's why it's missing. Now apologize to each other.
Sorry.
And guys, maybe you're all right. We are lost. I'm looking at this map, and it just doesn't make any sense. I'm sorry we're all stuck here.
Don't worry, Danielle. Look, I brought a phone. With this, I'm going to call my uncle, Uncle Scully. Remember him from last year? He worked at an office called Emergency 3D.
Don't you mean Agency D3?
Agency T3? What kind of name is that? Don't you know the song? It goes like this. Emergency 3D. Demolish, destroy, defend. Don't you know? Wait, guys. I think I hear it ringing.
Hello?
It's Uncle Scully. Hi.
Who's this?
It's Afonso.
Afu-who?
It's Afonso!
Oh, Afonso! How's my not-so-little nephew doing?
I'm doing great!
Good for you! So, what's up, buddy?
I don't know, not much.
Afonso, tell him we're lost!
Hold on a second, uncle. Excuse me, Danielle. Don't you know it's impolite to interrupt someone on the phone? Anyways, so, how was your day today?
Oh, it was great! Today I had two large sandwiches with...
Uncle Scully! Two sandwiches with what? Two sandwiches with what?
What happened?
He said he ate two sandwiches, but he didn't tell me with what! Oh, and the battery died.
Are you serious? Now we're gonna be lost forever!
Shannon, keep your head up. I'm sure we'll find ourselves out of this mess.
Ah, spider!
Oh my gosh, Matt, get off of me! That's just a leaf!
It was moving, I'm serious!
Yeah, because of the wind. Can we just set up camp here? I'm really tired and the sun is setting.
Yeah, good idea, guys. I'll be back. I'm gonna go pray.
Whatever.
But Danielle, don't leave me.
Shannon, wait, take
care. Come on. You need to sit down and get some rest, or who knows what will happen to you.
Man, today was such a long day. I thought God guided us here to this jungle so that I could find clues about my father. But everything's been just going so wrong. Shannon's uncomfortable. Afonso's hungry every second. Matthew's scared of everything. Maybe it was a mistake coming here. Am And whenever you turn to the right or to the left, your ears will hear this command behind you. This is the way, walk in it. Isaiah 30, 21. God, I know you can hear me. You always listen to my prayers. God, we need you. We're so hungry and so lost. Everyone's losing hope. Should I just turn around and go back home? God, I know you're there, so please be with us. Be our one true guide. We love you. And in Jesus' name we pray, amen. Village? A village? A village! I need to go tell my friends! Guys, wake up! What? Guys!
What?
I think there's a village nearby.
Wait, a village? Doesn't that mean food?
Maybe. There's a sign leading us towards the village.
We've been through this before. There are no villages in this area.
Come on, let's go. Trust me.
But they better have Wi-Fi. Slow down!
Or a bathroom.
Ew!
I hope there's food there.
So where is this village?
It says the village should be right here. What?
Ugh. I found a mirror and I look fabulous.
Hello? Anybody?
Pretty sure there's no villages around this area, Danielle.
This can't be right.
McDonald's, Taco Bell, Chick-fil-A, are you here?
Hello? Oh.
There's no villages. I don't see anything.
Just keep looking for clues.
Fine. Wait, you guys, look.
Yeah, Shannon, we know you look beautiful.
No, look. I think I found something.
What?
Wait,
what's going on? What's this sound?
Where is the sound coming from?
What the?
What is going on?
Visitors to Waka Wiki Village. I am Varen, the village chief. Who are you?
Hi, I'm Danielle, and this is Shannon.
Hi, do you guys have Wi-Fi here or no?
And this is Matthew. Matthew, say hi.
Hi.
Sorry, he's a bit shy. And lastly, here we have, guys, where did Afonso go?
You guys, look! I found so much food in this village! See? I think I found a french fries, I think, and a corn dog, I think. And right now I'm eating this fried chicken!
Afonso, you can't just do that. It's impolite.
Hey, is that my food? You know you're stealing.
Shom, that is perfectly all right. We have plenty of food here at Waka Wiki Village.
And is that my chicken that I've been saving since last week? Spit it out! That's my chicken!
Shom, would you please take our guests' bags to their rooms?
But sir, I've been saving that for weeks. Spit it out!
Shom, take our guests' bags.
Right away, chief.
There you go.
Where these kids came out of nowhere, I just forgot to take all their stuff.
Wait, wait, you have to take these too. Wait, you forgot this one.
Now, let me show you to some of our village residents. Here we have Adelphos, our village fisherman.
Heyo!
If you need to know anything about fishing, Adelphos is your man.
Did you say fishing? Move, get out! I love fishing!
Me too!
Me three!
Me comes after three.
Four!
Uh-huh!
Well, so where do you guys go fishing?
We go fishing at the Wakawiki Lake.
Oh, that sounds so fun. What kind of fish do you catch?
Let's see here. We catch jellyfish.
Uh-huh.
Goldfish.
Uh-huh.
That's it.
Oh, so do you guys cook the fish and eat it?
Darn right I do. First, we cut them.
Uh-huh.
Then we grill them.
Uh-huh.
Then add a little seasoning.
Yeah.
And then we eat it. It's very delicious.
Come on, Adolfo. You have to take me fishing with you.
All right, youngster. I guess we could go fishing before the big yellow ball in the sky goes down. Hold on. Let me ask my daughter if she wants to go fishing.
Okay.
Hey, Honey Biscuit.
What, Dad?
Do you want to go fishing before night night? Our buddy, what's your name, buddy?
My name's Afonso.
Afonso wants to go fishing.
For the 500th time. No, Dad. Fishing is gross. Ew.
Well, I guess we're on our own, buddy. Come on. I'll let you try on my new boots.
Yes! See you guys later.
Wait, Afonso?
I believe he'll be in good hands.
Oh, I'm sure, but we don't want to get too ahead of ourselves.
What's going on here?
And here we have Cheryl.
I can't believe my dad's going fishing on my half birthday. I'm turning 16 and a half. Oh, who's this?
Hi, I'm Shannon.
Girlfriend, I love your shoes.
Wait, and I love your necklace.
Thank you, I made myself.
No way.
Yahweh.
Cheryl is our village fashion designer. She has very good taste.
Wait, if you made this, can you make me one too?
Of course, only if you show me your shoe collection.
Wait, do you like them? I had these custom made.
No way.
Yahweh. Wait, girl, before we do that, can we take a selfie?
Self what?
Here, just smile. See?
Oh, we look fabulous.
I know, right?
Let's go take more selfie. Selfie? By the river.
It's pronounced selfies.
Oh,
selfie.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay, let's go.
Danielle. Who is that?
Oh, don't worry, Matt. I'm sure she's harmless.
No, no, that's not why I'm hiding. She's gorgeous.
You should go talk to her.
I can't. I'm too shy. What if she doesn't like how I look? Or what if my breath stinks?
Ah! What? Does your breath stink?
No. It smells amazing.
Then go, or I'll go talk to her myself
no, no, no,
and
please,
introduce
please.
You. Hi!
Ah!
Don't hit me! Oh, no, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to scare you. I'm Danielle. We're visiting here.
Oh, sorry. I get scared easily. I'm Matea.
Nice to meet you. So, what do you do here?
Well, nothing dangerous. Usually, I knit or I clean, and sometimes I like to go flower picking. But if I feel extra adventurous, I go berry picking by myself.
Oh, wow. You really need to meet my friend, Matt.
Hi. I really like your helmet. Are you okay?
I just... wait. Is that a bug? Ah! Did I do that? Did I do that? I'm a monster. I'm a monster!
Wait, Matt, come back! What was that?
That was very weird.
Well, that's for sure.
Well, what brings you here, Danielle?
Well, I'm here to find some clues about my father, who went missing in this jungle 4 years ago. He might be in heaven now, but I still want to find out what exactly happened to him.
Well, I am very sorry to hear that. I am sure there is something we could do to help. What was he doing in this part of the region?
He was teaching villages about God.
Who?
God.
Goat? Who is this goat?
No, not goat. God. Wait, you've never heard of God before? I'm sure my father's been to every single village on this map.
Tell me more about this goat. Is he furry? Why do people worship him?
God. G-O-D. God. He's not an animal. God.
Chief, your afternoon bath is ready.
Ah, thank you, Shom. By the way, do you know who this god is?
Goat? Yes, I have 3 goats.
No,
why do you ask?
Not goat, god! Is there something wrong with this village?
A what? No, I've never heard of that before.
Wait, this village doesn't know who God is? Then who do you guys pray to or worship?
Why, me, of course. I pray to myself all the time. I give the villagers what they need, and in turn, they worship me. They worship me 27 times a day. It is in Varen, in me, that they trust.
Me?
No, not you, me.
Maybe there is something wrong with you.
I believe you are just tired and talking nonsense. You must need some rest. If you need anything, I am sure Shom can help you and your friends. Now, let's say we meet later in the afternoon, after you've had your rest. Until then, good day, Danielle. Shom, can you go fluff my pillows?
Ah, yes. Would you like the soft kind? Would you like kind of soft? Would you like the really, really extremely soft kind? You just fall into it like a pillow, you just like sleep into it?
Just
one of those?
Just soft, Shom.
Right away, Chief.
That's so odd. How is it that out of all these villagers, not a single person knows who God is? There's something fishy about this village. I need to pray to God and see what He wants me to do.
Wow! Can you believe that? It's only day one, but we embarked upon a journey and so much happened. Danielle and her friends were in search for her father, but unexpectedly they went into a village. Waki Wiki Village, was it? And they met so many friends there. Oh man. Oh, by the way, friends, my name is Kim Watson, and I'm gonna be your adventure guide for the next 5 days as we go on a journey to find out who is our true guide. This guide is very important because he is the guide that made us, and he is the one that we must follow. I know on this journey, friends, things can get a little bit confusing, and at times, we might get a little lost, just like Danielle and her friends, but if you trust in this one guide, the one guide who made us, who's God, I think we're gonna be okay. I'm still waiting for my trusty partner. I don't know where he is.
Watson!
Speaking of, here
Watson!
He is. Here, Jones!
Watson! Hey!
Hi!
Watson, you would not believe what I found!
What did you find?
Whoa! What's with all the small pygmies out there?
Oh! Remember I told you that we're going on a journey and we have some explorers joining us?
Ah! Welcome, fellow explorers and adventurers! Don't worry, you're in great hands with California Jones, one of the best archaeologists and guides in all of the jungle!
Jones, I don't know if we want to trust this guy. We might get a little lost.
Wait a minute, what's that, Watson?
Nothing. Hey, do you have something?
I do. You wouldn't believe what I found in that cave back there.
Wait, the cave that I specifically told you not to go into?
Well, Watson. I had to go in there to get this, and there were... Well, I only woke up one gorilla.
What? You did what? The angry gorillas? Oh, no, Jones.
It's
they're
all gonna right. All right, calm down, Watson, because I got this.
Ooh.
Look at it. It's a piece of copper light.
Wait, wait. Did you say copper light?
Yes, I did.
Like
that
it...
there is poop.
Like real poop?
Dinosaur poop.
Ah!
Right out of the back end of
a dinosaur.
Oh! Watson, calm down. It's fossilized. It's been hard enough.
Oh, no, thank you.
Years. Do you know what this little piece of poop can tell us?
No. Such as, where did dinosaurs come from? Where do we come from? Where does life come from?
That's right.
Well, I have the very thing that could tell us.
Watson, you're not going to read a story from that book again, are you? Save that for the children.
Actually, this book is not just a book, but it's the truth. And I turn to it every time I have questions about my life. All right, so where does this life come from? It says here in Genesis, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was formless and empty. There was nothing there, but God's Spirit hovered over the surface. Then God said, "Let there be light." And God separated the light from the dark and called the light day, and he called the dark night. And then God created the skies and the land on the second day. Imagine that! And God also, on the third day, decided to do more creating, and he decided to make the land and the dry seas and all the plants and vegetations to start filling the earth. So by the third day, the earth started to get really, really full and dense with all this vegetation. Then on the fourth day, it says here that God made the sun, the moon, and the stars to appear in the land to be lights that govern the skies. Do you know why we have stars and moons? It's because God made it and shows us the seasons. Not only that, on the fifth day, God created the birds in the sky, the fishes in the sea, all the little critters that fly and move about. He told them, "Be fruitful and multiply," and they did. Not only that, and on the sixth day, Jones, it says here that God created all the land animals, all according to their kinds. The creepy ones, the slithering ones, the ones that walked about on their 4 feet, and the ones that even had hair. God made all of it, and he said, "It is good." But he saved the best part for last.
What was that, Watson?
It was his masterpiece, actually. God says, "Let us make mankind in our own image to rule over all of creation." So this is what God did. He created a man and a woman in his own image. The Bible says God made you and God made me. And he didn't just make us, but he made us in his image. And he said, "We are very good."
Watson, I don't know what to say. That is, it's...
true.
It's ridiculous, Watson. How can you believe that all of that stuff was made in the wink of an eye?
It wasn't by a wink, but it was by God's word. All of this happened. And you better believe it. He is the one that created you and me, and that's why we can trust him as our guide.
Watson, I'm sorry, but there's only one person that I trust. Just like Chief Barron back in the Milwaukee Wiki Village, I trust myself. I take care of myself.
Right. You take care of yourself, which is why you walked into a gorilla trap I told you not to go into. And you also woke up one gorilla. Is that right?
Oh,
do you hear that, Watson? Oh, no. Oh, I think they can smell you. Oh, it's the poop. It's the poop.
We gotta get out of here.
Oh, what am I gonna do? Friends, would you trust that guy? I wouldn't either. I think we're gonna get lost if I follow Jones. Remember that on this journey, there is only one guide that we should follow. His name is... absolutely. And friends, when you follow this guide, I promise that you're not going to get lost, but he will lead you in the right direction. So in order for him to lead us today, can I pray for us? Let's pray. Dear God, we believe that you are the one true God that made us, created us, and shows us the right way. I pray for all my friends here at Toontown that they will listen to you and follow your ways because your way is the best way. Lead us today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Friends, why don't we get up on our feet so you can go